Hi students, good afternoon everybody. Today we are going to see the last part of the prose, Two Gentlemen of Verona. So in the previous class we have seen that the two brothers Nicola and Jacopo, they were going to a place called Puleta, taken by the narrator in his car. So the narrator was wondered by looking at the large villa where the two brothers are getting down. So now let us have the continuation. So we shall not be long, sir, perhaps only an hour. So the two brothers are telling to the narrator, we are not going to spend a very long time here, just will be returning back within an hour. So maybe you would like to go to the cafe in the village for a drink. Okay, so they are telling the narrator that you may go to the coffee shop in the village and you might have a drink there. So they disappeared beyond the corner of the wall. So by saying so, they are disappearing, that is, they are getting inside the house. After a few minutes, I followed. So after the two brothers were getting in, the narrator is deciding or thinking to follow Nicola and Jacopo. I found a grilled side entrance and determinedly rang the bell. So the narrator was able to find a side entrance which is grilled, that is, which is protected by a grill or which is covered with a grill, and determinedly rang the bell. So, and he had decided that he wants to see what is happening inside the house or what they are doing inside the house. So he is ringing the bell. A pleasant looking woman with steel rimmed spectacles appeared. So after ringing the bell, a woman is coming out and she was very pleasant, very pleasing to look at, and she is wearing a spectacles which is made of steel rim. I blinked as I saw that she was dressed in the white uniform of a trained nurse. So he was hidden, so it is just a house, very large house, so he didn't expect a nurse to come out of the house. So he was just blinking at her because she was wearing a white dress which is noted for the nurses. So I just brought two small boys here. So he was telling to the nurse, I have just brought those two boys here, that is, to this place. Ha, yes, her face lit up. She opened the door to admit me. So she is telling, oh yes. And her face lit up. So lit is the past participle of light. So her face brightened. She opened the door to admit me. She is opening the door so that the narrator might get inside. So Nicola and Jacopo, I'll take you up. Okay, so those two boys, Nicola and Jacopo, so definitely I will take you to them. So the nurse is telling to the narrator. She led me through a cool tiled vestibule into the hospital. For hospital, the villa had become. Okay, so she is taking the author, narrator, through a cool tiled vestibule. So what is vestibule? So vestibule is a hall or a path or a passage. Okay, so which will be opening into some other room or some other hall or some other path or passage like that. Okay, that is called as vestibule. So she is taking the narrator in the vestibule, through the vestibule into the hospital. For hospital, the villa had become. Okay, so the villa was just built for a hospital, or they had transformed the villa as a hospital. At the door of a little cubicle, the nurse passed, put her finger to her lips and with a smile bade me look through the glass partition. Okay, so at the door of a little cubicle. Okay, what does mean by cubicle? So cubicle is a small room that is separated from a large room. Okay, so in a large room, a small chamber or a small room is separated out of a large room, that is called as cubicle. So at the door of a little cubicle, the nurse passed. So the nurse stopped at the door of the cubicle, put her fingers to her lips. So she is keeping her fingers on her lips and with a smile bade me look through the glass partition. Okay, so bade. So bade is the past participle of bid. So she is, so the meaning of the bade here is told or directed or instructed, ordered, advised. So we can take in many sense. So here the meaning of the bed is, she is with a smile, she is asking the or telling the or instructing the narrator to look through the glass partition, that is the separation. The two boys were seated at the beside of a girl of about 20 who propped up on pillows, wearing a pretty lace jacket, was listening to their chatter, her eyes soft and tender. Okay, so the two boys were, so the narrator was able to see the two boys sitting beside a girl whose age might be around 20, propped up on pillows. So how she was sitting is, she was resting on a pillows. Okay, so wearing a pretty lace jacket. So propped means she was sitting in a seated in a resting position on the pillows, wearing a pretty lace jacket. So she's wearing a beautiful, pretty. Okay, so beautiful jacket, that is an outer garment made of lace. Was listening to their chatter. So, and she was listening to the conversation made by the two boys, that is Nicola and Jacopo. Her eyes soft and tender. So how her eyes were is, so her eyes were looking very soft and tender, that is very delicate, with a kind and with a love. Okay, so one could see at a glance her resemblance to her brothers. So just with a view we can identify that she is resembling her two brothers, that is we will be able to identify that they were brothers and sisters because their resemblance is almost same. So a vase of wild flowers stood on her table beside a dish of fruit and several books. Okay, so there was a flower vase which is with a flowers which is on her table beside a dish of fruit, and also there was a dish which is made of fruit and several books, and also some books were there on the table. "Won't you go in?" the nurse murmured. So the nurse is asking, so she is murmuring. Murmuring means talking in a very low voice. Okay, so she was asking to the narrator, "Won't you go in? Lucia will be pleased to see you." Okay, so what is the name of her? Their sister is Lucia, that is Nicola, Jacopo and Lucia were brothers and sister. Okay, so if you get inside, Lucia will be pleased, that is she will be very happy to see you, the nurse is telling to the narrator. "I shook my head and turned away." Okay, so the narrator is shaking his head, that is he was not willing to get inside and turned away. So turned away is a phrasal verb, find the meaning. "I felt I could not bear to intrude upon this happy family party." Okay, so I felt, so the narrator was not interested in getting inside because he felt what he felt is he could not bear to intrude upon this happy family party. So he was not interested in entering inside and disturbing them, that is they were discussing something, that is they were in a chatter, that is in a chat or a conversation. So he was not interested in disturbing them, entering and disturbing them. "But at the foot of the staircase I drew up and begged her to tell me all she knew about these boys." But the narrator is asking to the nurse, that is he was begging to the nurse. Okay, at the foot of the, so at the staircase, you know, staircase means steps. So at the foot of the staircase I drew up. So drew up is a phrasal verb, it means to stop in front of something or somebody. Okay, so drew up is a phrasal verb. You can search draw up also. So at the foot of the staircase I drew up and begged her to tell me all she knew about these boys, and she is asking to the nurse about the details of these boys. So she was eager to do so. The nurse was very interested in explaining or giving the information about those two boys. The nurse explained, quite alone in the world except for the sister Lucia. Okay, so they were quite alone in the world. They doesn't have any other relationship in the world except their sister Lucia. Their father, a widower. So they don't have mother. Their father was a widower, a well-known singer. Okay, so he was a well-known singer, had been killed in the early part of the war. So he was killed in the early part of the during the World War. Shortly afterward, a bomb had destroyed their home and thrown the three children into the streets. So as it was a war time, so their bomb had destroyed their home and thrown the three children into their streets. So during a bomb blast, their home was completely destroyed and they were standing in the streets. They had always known a comfortable and cultured life. Lucia had herself been training as a singer, and they had suffered horribly from near starvation and exposure to the cold winter. Okay, so they had always known a comfortable, so they lived a very comfortable and very cultured life. Lucia had herself been training as a singer. So Lucia was training herself to become a singer, and they had suffered horribly from near starvation. Okay, starvation means a feeling of extreme hunger. Okay, so and they had suffered terribly, very horribly from near starvation and exposure to the cold winter, and also they cannot withstand the very climate, that is the cold winter. For months they had barely kept themselves alive in a sort of shelter they built with their own hands amidst the rubble. Okay, for many months they had barely, so here again barely is a semi-negative word. For months they had barely kept themselves alive in a sort of shelter they built with their own hands amidst, in the middle of, the rubble. Okay, rubble means broken stones or broken bricks. So they had built a small house, that is a place to live, with their own hands, with their that is of their own, with the broken bricks. Then for 3 years, the Germans ruled the city. So after that, for 3 years, the Germans ruled the city. The boys grew to hate the Germans. Okay, so the boys hated the Germans. When the resistance movement began secretly to form, they were among the first to join. Okay, so when the resistance movement began. Okay, so when there was a movement which was started to oppose the Germans, so these boys were the first to join them because they were hating the Germans. When the war was over and we had peace at last, they came back to their beloved sister. Okay, so when the war was over, the two brothers were again coming back to their sister, and they found her suffering from tuberculosis of the spine. So only at that time they were finding their sister suffering from a disease called tuberculosis of the spine. She passed, took a quick breath. Okay, so after telling this, the nurse is taking a pass. Did they give up? I do not have to answer that question. They brought her here, persuaded us to take her into the hospital. Okay, so after returning from the war only, the two brothers were able to find that their sister was suffering from a disease called tuberculosis of the spine, but they did not give up. Okay, so give up is again a phrasal verb, find it. I do not have to answer that question. They brought her here. So they didn't give up their sister. So they had taken their sister there, that is to that villa, that is to the hospital. They brought her here, persuaded us to take her into the hospital. So they requested us to admit her in the hospital. In the 12 months, she has been our patient. She has made good progress. Okay, so for the past 12 months, she was our patient and there was a very good progress, very good improvement in her health. There is every hope that one day she will walk and sing again. Okay, so there is every hope. So we are very confident that one day definitely she is going to recover very soon and she'll be able to walk again and sing again. Of course, everything is so difficult now. Food so scarce and dear, we could not keep going unless we charged a fee. So of course, so what is the fact is, everything is so difficult now. So food, giving sufficient food, so everything is very difficult without charging a fees. But every week, Lucia's brothers have made their payment. Okay, but every week, definitely they'll be coming here and paying for her. She added simply, "I don't know what they do. I do not ask." Okay, so the nurse is telling, "I don't know how they are paying. I do not ask them. I was not interested in asking them how they are paying. Work is scarce in Verona, perhaps, and also getting a job or getting a work in Verona is also very difficult. It is very scarce. But whatever it is, I know they do it well." Okay, but however it is, whatever it is, I know they do it well. So here they do it well means the meaning is, that is, they are not earning the money in a bad way. Okay, have a very great confidence on them that they are earning the money in a good way and not in a evil way, that is, not in a bad way. "Yes, I agreed. They could not do it better." Okay, so "yes, I agreed," the narrator is telling, yes, they are doing, that is, they are earning the money in a better way. "I waited outside until the boys rejoined me and then drove them back to the city." So the narrator was waiting outside until the boys joined them and then drove them back to the city, and again three of them were going back to Verona. "They sat beside me, not speaking." So the two brothers were sitting beside the narrator and they were not speaking anything to the narrator. "For my part, I did not say a word. I knew they would prefer to feel that they had safely kept their secret." Okay, so "for my part, I did not say a word." So the narrator is not declaring anything that he had got inside the hospital. And with the help of the nurse, he had seen their sister. So he was not interested in declaring anything to the two brothers because they might prefer it, keeping it as a secret. Okay, so the narrator was not interested in telling anything. "Yet their devotion had touched me deeply." Their devotion had touched me deeply. So what is devotion? That is the great love for their sister. Okay, the love which the two brothers have there for their sister had deeply touched the narrator. "War had not broken their spirit. Their selfless action brought a new nobility to human life, gave promise of a greater hope for human society." Okay, their selfless action brought a new nobility. So what is nobility? Quality of being with courage and honor. Okay, that is called as nobility. So their selfless action brought a new nobility to human life, gave promise of a greater hope for human society. Okay, so it is giving a great confidence to the human society. So why this process named as Two Gentlemen of Verona is because those two boys were very gentle. Okay, so they were doing all sorts of work. They were getting to earn money, and also they were earning money not for their personal purpose. Okay, not for their dressing, not for their good dressing, or not for their leading a luxurious life, or for having a very variety of food. Okay, so they were earning the money only for the sake of their sister. Okay, so they were earning it in a honorable manner. Okay, they were not doing any mischief. Okay, so that's why they were called as gentlemen. Okay, so here our prose gets ends. Now, in the page number 6. So you have your textual questions in the next pages. In the page number 6, read the following words taken from this story. Give two synonyms and one antonym for each of these words. Use a dictionary if required. So cautious, disapprove, brisk, engaging, humble, eager, resistance, pursued, scarce, nobility. So I hope for all these words we have seen synonyms, I hope. So you have to write two synonym and an antonym. Okay. Next, homophones and confusables. Okay. So all of you, we have seen in the previous, in the near 10th and 11th standard itself, what is homophones. Okay. So homo means same, phone means sound. Okay. So a word that is pronounced the same as another word but has a different spelling and meaning, that is called as homophone. Okay. Homo means same, phone means sound. So same sound, different spelling and different meaning, it is called as homophones. Okay. So you have already learned that homophones are words that sound alike but are different in spelling and meaning. So their pronunciation, their sound will be same, but it has a different spelling and different meaning. See, for example, feet, feet. So both are pronounced as feet, but both of them has different spelling and different meaning. Face, face. Okay. Sorry, face, face, sword, sword, hair, hair. So all this has same pronunciation but their spelling and meaning are different. So find the meaning of all these words. Okay, next, what are confusables? Okay, there is not much difference between homophones and confusables. Okay, sometimes confusables were also called as confusable homophones. Okay, so confusables are otherwise called as confusables. Okay, confusables or confusables are words that are commonly confused with one another in meaning or usage because of slight similarities in spelling, pronunciation or meaning. Okay, so listen, here the pronunciation will be different. In the homophone, the pronunciation is same, but the meaning and spelling are different. Here, see, there is a slight difference in the pronunciation. For example, moment, movement, except, expect, human, humane. So, most of the time, we will be pronouncing this also as human, but it is humane, human, humane. Discover, invent. So there is difference between discover and invent. Okay, so there is nothing, a small difference between homophones and confusables. In the homophones, the pronunciation will be same. In the confusables, there will be a slight difference in the pronunciation. Okay, so and also it will be varying in the spelling and also in the meaning. Okay, it is called as confusables. Okay, now, given below is a list of common confusables. Distinguish the meaning of each pairs of words by framing your own sentences. Okay, so here what you have to do is, given below is a list of common confusables. So, confusables are given here. Distinguish the meaning of each pair of words by framing your own sentences.
Okay, how to frame sentence of your own and differentiate their meaning. So, emigrate, immigrate, beside, besides, judicial, judicious, eligible, illegible, conscience, conscious, industrial, industrious, eminent, imminent, illicit, illicit, prescribed, proscribed, affect, effect, oral, oral, born, born. Okay, so how to frame sentences, find the meaning and then frame your sentences. Next, fill in the blanks with suitable homophones or confusables. Okay, so you can either use homophones or confusables. So as I said already, homophones will have same pronunciation, but in the confusables, the meaning will be in a confusing manner and also there will be a slight change in the pronunciation. See here, here in all this words, you can find the pronunciation is different. Okay, so there will be a slight change in the pronunciation in confusables. Okay, so you can either fill this with homophones or confusables, but you have to note it whether it is a homophone or confusable. Okay. Okay, students, thank you. Let us see in the next class.